These fascinating facts I would now like to understand from Mr. Mukherjee. What is the importance of mini grids in the energy access space? And also, can you throw some light on how SPI designs its mini grids program in rural communities?
All right. Thank you, Megha, and good evening, everyone. Before I dive into Smart Power's DRE-led mini grid program, let me provide some context about India's electricity services and really frame the problem that we are trying to address through our DRE initiatives. Over the last few decades, India has made significant strides both on the generation side, including growth in renewable generations, as well as in the electricity grid expansion and connectivity. Thanks to the, you know, the accelerated program over the last 7-8 years called the Subhagya program, the grid is omnipresent now everywhere in the rural, and nearly 100% household level connections have been achieved, and which we have witnessed during the 5-6 years of our groundwork. So these are extremely laudable achievements. India has more than adequate generation capacity. Currently, 55-60% of the generation capacity is being used, and there is a significant upside in terms of, you know, as electricity demand grows. But despite these laudable achievements, here is the paradox. Diesel consumption and diesel usage for electricity continues to be extremely high. In fact, I understand the figures are around between 35-45 billion liters of diesel usage, and the low income states have a, you know, even higher proportion of diesel usage. The diesel generator manufacturers are predicting sales growth of 12.5% compounded annually. So you have, you know, tremendous generation capacity, you have grid everywhere, and you also have this paradox of you know, extremely high diesel usage continuing. Then comes another problem, which is the per capita electricity consumption, which we all agree is a close proxy to measuring economic progress of a community or a country. India's per capita electricity consumption is 1/3 of the world, and Indian rural electricity consumption is probably about 1/10 of the world. And no wonder, you know, what you see there, you can easily correlate to the conditions and the economic conditions that are prevailing. So this brings us to, you know, this is the paradox that we are looking at. And, you know, in the survey that Smart Power India and Niti Aayog did across 10 states, to survey a primary research to survey over 10,000 customers, households, as well as commercial and enterprise customers, we found that 40% of commercial and enterprise customers in UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, and northeastern states, accounting for 45% of the country's population, 40% have not connected to the grid and are primarily reliant on diesel. And of the remaining 60%, only 10% have adequate electricity via the grid, which means more than 18 hours plus, you know, the World Bank framework for electricity consumption. And 60%-80% have just the tier one access, which is less than 12 hours and, you know, 2 kilowatt connectivity, sometimes single phase. So you understand why so much diesel is being used. And this is where our program actually comes in. And the Smart Power program, which has been now in its 6th year, has built in partnership with about 10 private sector players, about 500 mini grids, probably the largest portfolio of renewable energy mini grids anywhere in the world. And growing at the rate of 100-200 in India every year. So these mini grids have served a key role in addressing, supplementing and bringing reliability, displacing diesel. But our program takes an holistic approach. We not only address the supply side, we look at how to expand enterprise activity. We look at how to bring in new enterprise development.
It seems that we have lost Mr. Mukherjee.
About more than 25,000. More than 25,000. Excuse me. Is there?
Sorry, we had lost you for a minute.
Sorry.
But please go ahead.
More than 25,000 CNI customers connected to the. Are we connected now? Okay.
Yes,
more than 25,000. Yeah, more than 25,000 CNI customers are now connected. Or has eliminated diesel to the extent of, there's a elimination of 20,000 tons of CO2 per year from these mini grids. So this is, some of the critical, this explains why criticality of DRE solutions in the the rural economy of India, not only driving the economy, creating justice in terms of electricity, but also the environmental impact side. And in course of our work in the rural areas, we recognize another opportunity for expanding our DRE work when we found that the customers with 5 to 10 to 20 kilowatt individual requirement us cannot be serviced by the mini grids. And we are now about to launch expansion to our programs to drive solar rooftop for commercial and enterprise customers in the rural, because that market is constrained by, again, high risk, access to finance, and viable business model. So this is another addition to our DRE program that we are about to, bring on the road in the coming months. And again, pointing to the fact that how critical the DRE solutions are going to be, not only in just energy transition, but driving the economic progress of our rural communities. Thank you.
Thank you. This was great to know how mini grids bring into so many advantages to the communities, and really good plans that Smart Power India has to get this economic development run going on and bring opportunity to increase the per capita consumption and a more sustainable lifestyle.